Hi dear participants, my name is Nazlı Irkıl. I am attend from Didi University at Turkey. We study with this presentation with Professor Erhan Bişkin. First of all, I would like to thank the committee for giving me the chance to attend the webinar. The title of our presentation is On Behavior of Solutions to Algorithmic Wave Equation with Nonlinear Dynamical Boundary Conditions. In this presentation, we studied the following problem. I want to give some information about to our problems. You can see we can call this type problem wave equations, and we have initial and boundary conditions for our problems. The first conditions is related with the initial conditions, and the second and the other conditions are related with the boundary conditions. And you can see we have the damping terms, and because of these terms, we can say we have the logarithmic source terms. We studied this problem in a bounded domain, and we called this domain with omega. The omega is a regular domain, and this boundary of omega domain can be called with del omega, and del omega is defined with gamma zero and gamma two, and we give some conditions for gamma zero and gamma two. You can see at these conditions, and we must have some features for k and p, and you can see k and p big equal to two, and these constants are positive. And we give some features again about to this positive constants when we study the global existence or the blow-up results. You know, differential equations also play a central role in mathematics. Many problems in science, engineering, medicine are modeled as a differential equations. Therefore, it is very important to find solution to these problems. But every time we couldn't give solutions for this problem. So we try to find the mathematical behavior of this solution or numerical solutions. When we start to look the literature, we can see there is a lot of work about the qualitative theory of these equations, these problems. For example, we can look for local existence, global existence, asymptotic behavior suggests the decay or growth of solutions, and the blow-up, global non-existence of these solutions. It's an important area for the mathematicians. In the absence of the logarithmic source term and for negative source term, our problems like one was studied by Chan, Legnus, and Zuozhou. In the absence of the damping term without UT and for the logarithmic for the source term, if we taken at this form, this problem was studied by Levine and Paine and Levine and Smith in the in different times. Levine and Paine obtained the blow up results for the negative initial energy. Levine and Smith studied the global existence under suitable initial conditions. Then later Vicilaro studied the our problems one without logarithmic source term, and he take the source term as a polynomial source term. And the other obtained local and global existence in bounded domains. Later, they at all and 2020 near the times considered nighttime blow up of solutions at critical energy level or high energy level. We can say again, at this problem, the authors don't take the logarithmic source term for the their problems. Now we can must give information about the logarithmic nonentity. Well, equations with the logarithmic nonentity have many applications in many branches of physics, such as optics, geophysics, and nuclear physics. The first works was obtained by Bjarnisky, Virula, and Misaski in 1975. It was a classical field equation whose popularity increased, especially when it was shown in Bulgin and Virula and Misaski. In recent years, hyperbolic wave equations with logarithmic source term have attracted much attention. In 1980, Jezenove studied the Eggleston solutions, the following equation you can see in 2, in R3. Later, Gorka studied the global axis of the SEM equation in the one-dimensional case. There is a lot of works about two logarithmic source terms with different problems, for example, for Kirchhoff equations, or Laplacian type equations, viscoelastic terms, and they the other studies the different theory of these problems. For example, blow up. For example, global existence. And we refer the concerned reader for the study of different kinds of this type problem. You can see Chen and Liu, Pişkin and Çalışır. And we studies this area very attractive. Kapine and Mesudi studies at this area. You can see in our reference. To best of our knowledge, logarithmic wave equation with dynamic boundary condition has not been studied yet. So our aim is in this presentation paper is to extend the blow-up results for this type problem. For this, we must define some norms and unique products and some lemmas which will be used in our proof. First, we denote the norms which is related with our energy functionals, and we define T. And we define Banach space and a supplemum of Banach space. You can see in our presentations. Then we define the total energy of functions. It is very important for us. You can see our total energy function of related with the problem one, we give in three equal. According to definition of total energy, the initial energy for T equal to zero can be considered as at 2-4 equal. Then we will give some lemmas which will be used in our proofs. The lemma is about the the Sobolev and Bentic inequality. We firstly give some conditions, and our aim is to show that the norm of P and gamma 1 can be embedded to Hertz gamma 0, and we give this inequality in pi. The other propositions is related with the logarithmic source term. Because of we have the logarithmic source term, we couldn't use the trace Sobolev and Bentic directly. So we must have some conditions for this. And at these propositions, we give some conditions for this lemma. The other lemma is about so our total energy, the differential of total energy, and we can say our total energy is non-increasing function, and we can state the function inequality in three. For the proof of this, first we will multiply the equation one by ut and integrating on omega, and we use some Green formula, and we have the inequality 6. The other lemma is about the logarithmic source term. Our aim is to estimate the logarithmic source term and write these terms as a known. So we must use the lemma 3, and you can see the following inequality 7 we will use for the global existence and for the blow up lizards, these lemmas. The local existence, we give the only theorem, but we not give the proof of this theorem in our presentations. We use the Pedro-Galerkin method and Schroeder fixed point theorem for our proof. In proof, our aim is to show that the every norms can be bonded in a domain, and we can say our problems have a local existence for 0 to t. We considered the theorem for related with local existence suggests. Firstly, we say we give information about t, and then we consider it the solution of the weak solution of the our problems one at this space, and we give the energy like as like, and we can say t equal to this conditions, and t is decreasing in the first variable. I say again, Pedro-Galerkin method will be used, and we try to give an approximation solution for local existence, and then we say the norms of these approximation solutions are bounded, so that we can extend the t from the tm to t, and we can have the local existence. We introduce the potential var. Potential var is important for us, for this, firstly we define the some useful functionals. The first functionals can be called as a potential functional. The other functional can be called as a Nihari functional. By combinations of 8 and 9. We have the 10, and later by the definitions of the total energy, we can the 11 equal. The potential space is important. Firstly, we can say the potential well depth is defined as 12, can be used for global existence. We can say if our solutions you under elements of the W, we can say we have a global existence. The we can say we use this space for the blow up results. Then we define the depth of potential well as the and D is derived with the potential functional lambda, lambda u.
Professor Oracle, sorry for interrupting, but you have 1 minute to
finish. Okay, I will go. We have potential well depths, and in lemma 5 we have root for equations. Later we have a proof. You can see at this. I want to come our blow up results. And the lemma 6 is right with the, our potential well depths, and we prove the that our that there is a positive content, and you can see the for level bond for D, and we have a proof. The our aims is the proof the lower bound for blow up time of the problem one. Firstly, I said we must have the that the all of the solutions U and UT must be element of V, and we prove this by contradictions. You can see. Later, our the main theorem is suggest. We can say the unital bond unital conditions element V, and under the these conditions over the P, our problem our solutions goes to the infinity when time goes to the t one minus. And we can have a level bond suggest. For this, firstly we define a function in 21. Then we test the problem one by UT, and we have the 22. By differentiating the HD, we and use this equal we have 23. Later, and because of the, our conditions, we can have a trace Sobolev bendings, and we can attend, we can get the this inequality, and for this we use the some logarithmic inequality for estimate the logarithmic sourcedan. And by insertion 24 into 23, we have this completes our proof. Our references is suggest. Thanks for your attention.